So then guys, today I have got the brand new iPad 2021 model, or the iPad 9th generation, whatever you want to call it. And today I'm going to test out, does the Office Suite or the Office 365 Suite, you know, what has Word, PowerPoint, Excel and many other apps, how well does it work on this brand new iPad, and can you do multitasking as well? So that's right guys, I have got myself the brand new iPad 9th generation, or the iPad 2021 model. And today I'm going to be testing out many of the Office apps out there. So I'm going to be testing out the usual ones of Word, PowerPoint, Excel, but I'm also going to be testing out the few extra ones like Microsoft Edge, for example, and also OneDrive and OneNote, and also like the ability to test out your emails in Outlook and one or two other apps as well. And then I'm going to show you how to install those apps, and then we're actually going to test those apps out. So let's begin. So I have already installed the new Office apps, but I'll show you how to do that in a second. But you can see I've got all the Office apps down the bottom here and a few more along here as well. But if you do want to install all these Office apps yourself, all you need to do is open up the App Store. So if we just go to the App Store here, and then afterwards into the search, let's put in Word, for example, and then just click on that. And then as you can see here, you've got Microsoft Word, and you can see I've already got it installed. But yeah, you've got all the information and everything there. I'll just go back here. We can also have a look for, I don't know, let's have a look for Edge, for example. So Microsoft, this is their browser that they have. So the same thing again, you've got Microsoft Edge, and then you can also do, let's say, PowerPoint. And then I'll just put that in. And there we go, you've also got PowerPoint as well, so you can install all these different apps. But let's begin then, and let's see how good Office is on this iPad. So let's open up Word first of all. Nice and snappy there, that was quick. Let's do a blank document. Wow, that was super fast. So let me just do a test here. So hi, this is a test, but look how quick and responsive this is on this 9th generation iPad. It's fantastic. I'm just going to play around here. I'm just going to see if I can make my font a bit different here. Let's just change the size a bit more bigger. Yep, that works perfectly well. And let's just also just change the actual font to, I don't know, let's go down to traditional Arial. There we go. Look at that. It's absolutely fantastic. So that's really good. And let's see if we can just like put a picture in as well. I went recently to this hot air balloon festival thing. Let's put hot air balloon in. Pulls it down from iCloud. And wow. There we go. There's my hot air balloon that I took on my iPhone. So yeah, that is brilliant. I can resize it and everything, can move it around the document any way I want. Really fast and snappy this is. There's no kind of lag or anything. But yeah, we can, I don't know, let's put like a background shadow on it if I wanted to. And it just did that instantly, no problems there. And then, you know, I've got all my different views and reviews and my layout and my draw and everything else like that. So Word is working really, really well on here. So let me just see if I can just save this up if I wanted to. So I'm just going to put that there and just push the save button. There we go. I can stick it on my OneDrive if I wanted to. I can stick it on my actual iPad as well. So yeah, that is working perfectly. So let's just keep that closed down then. I'm just going to press the home button. That closed down really quickly. And let's do PowerPoint next. And again, wow. That loaded really well and super fast. I'm just going to click this Berlin sort of theme here, and it just downloads that super fast. Let me just see again. If I double tap here the title, see if I can type something in. Let's call it test 2. This is the second test. And yeah, wow, look at that. That's just really, really good. Nice and vibrant on this iPad. But let's just see if I can just put another picture in. That's what PowerPoint is all about. Photos. Get my hot air balloon again. Let's select a different one this time. Now that's in, let's see if it does a theme for me. And there we go, look, it's recommending different themes, and that was really quickly how that loaded. So I'm really impressed with that. I can just adjust it again, I can zoom in. You know, you get the idea here. It is really, really quick on this 2021 iPad. I'm really impressed with this. I'm going to change it again. I'm going to put sort of a mirrored look underneath it, a reflection. So yeah, I'm really happy. We can also put an animation in if I wanted to, for it to how it's going to appear. So this is really, really good. I'm really happy with it. So let me just run a quick slideshow, see how it looks quickly. And there we go. Just going to tap the screen and voila, there's my picture. So I'm really, really impressive. I'm trying to get out of it now. There we go. And let's just end it down here. Let's just close the actual slideshow. And yeah, let's move on. So that is PowerPoint. Next of all, let's open up Excel. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to open up a new document here. Let's go to the new button. There we go. and open up really snappy. Let's just pick this budget one here. And I know what I'm going to do. I'm going to change some of the values here. Let's just change this value very simply from 2,500 to, I don't know, let's just call it 1,500. And let's just see what that will do. So if I just drag it up here, and if I click out, there we go. The amounts have changed, the pie charts change. So that is really, really amazing. It's nice and snappy and fast. I'm going to change the colors here if I can of this actual chart. Let's change it to this theme here. There we go. I like that color more than the black and green. The blue and green looks cooler. But Excel looks really, really good as well. I like all the different sort of elements, all the options here at the top. The ribbon works perfectly snappy and fast. So I'm really impressed with that.
So as you can see so far, this iPad is absolutely amazing. But something else what is truly amazing is to do with this channel. This channel recently got over 230,000 subscribers. So I've decided to do a giveaway for when we get over 260,000 subscribers. And that giveaway is for this. It's for a brand new iPad Pro. So you might as well have just got yourself a brand new iPad, but how would you like to get yourself an iPad Pro? Well, it's quite simple how you can get your hands on this model. All I want to know from you guys in the comments below is what Apple gear are you planning to buy in 2021? Maybe you've bought yourself this iPad that you've got right here, the 2029 ninth generation, or maybe you're going to be buying yourself a brand new iPhone or something else. Let me know in the comments below. And when we get over 260,000 subscribers, and that's not that far away from now, I'm going to be giving away this iPad Pro. The specs of this iPad Pro, it is a 12.9 inch model, and it also has 8GB of RAM and 256GB of storage. Also, after that you've basically written your comment below, make sure you subscribe to this channel at the same time and hit that notification bell. Because when we get over 260,000 subscribers, you'll want to get that notification to find out if you've been the lucky person to get your hands on this iPad Pro. Also at the same time as well, guys, if you're feeling generous and if you're enjoying this video so far, please also do press the like button. Well, let's continue on with the video.
Let's move on to Outlook next, the email client that opens up super quickly. My emails are coming through. Let's just do a compose here. Look at that, nice and snappy. And I could just start typing in people's names or a test, for example. And that works really well. I can't really show you all my emails, but let's move on next of all to looking at OneDrive. So I'm just going to open this up. And as you can see, that opened up really snappy and quickly. All my documents are there, all my files and all my photos as well. It's all loading up nicely. So yeah, really happy with that. Just a quick show of OneDrive there. So let's just close this down. And let's now move on to Teams. So again, I don't really use Teams here in my home life. I use it in my other sort of work life. But yeah, it's really, really quick and snappy. And I'm sure you'll be able to do some team meetings. You can add your recipients in here to start a meeting. But the app loaded instantly quickly. And I guess a lot of it depends on your broadband speed as well. So OneNote is next. And let's just quickly do a quick new page here. Let's do another test, for example. So let's put here iPad test. And let's just move down to the page here. Let's put in Love Office on iPad. And look at that, nice and snappy, nice quick note there. So that was really, really good as well. I'm really impressed with that. Again, you've got all your options at the top here if you want to, like highlighting and whatnot. But yeah, it looks really good, OneNote does. So next of all, I'm going to open up Edge. So Edge is the actual sort of browser from Microsoft, and look at that, loads up nice and quickly. And let's go to the Office website first of all, you know, why not? And oh, let's accept that. And yeah, that works in the search engine on Bing. In fact, I'm gonna go different. I'm not gonna go to Office, I'm gonna go to the Apple website. Why not? We're on an iPad here. Let's go wild. So we're just gonna open up Apple, and let's just click on the iPad because that's what we're on right now. Once it wants to load, there we go. And look at that, there we go, we got the iPads and everything. So that is absolutely fantastic. Really, really, really happy with that. So just scroll down here, everything looks really, really cool, nice and quick and responsive. Now I'm just going to close that down. Now one thing you might have noticed, I've not actually closed down the app. So if I double click here, I've got everything open, multitasking running in the background. So I can go to OneNote, for example, or let's say I can go to let's say Teams. And then let's say I want to flick over and let's say I want to open up Excel. It still just loads instantly. And let's go over to the first one, Word. Everything is just super quick here. So you can definitely run multiple Office apps at once on this iPad 2021 model. And that is super impressive. You can also move around your icons wherever you want them on the home screen. I just stuck it here. But you get the idea. It is really, really quick and really snappy. And I'm really impressed with this.
So as you can see, the 2021 iPad works perfect. The 2021 iPad is perfect for Office. You can basically open up all of the kind of Office or Microsoft Suite apps out there, and it just works absolutely fine on this iPad. There's no stuttering. Everything just works totally fine. So I'd highly recommend, if you want to get like Office Suite on an iPad, this iPad works perfectly fine with all of those apps. Well, guys, it's also time to wrap up this video. So if you have enjoyed watching it, please do press the like button. And also at the same time as well, if you want the latest Apple news, reviews and comparisons, please also hit that subscribe button followed by the notification bell. Until next time, guys, I'll see you soon. Bye bye.